Jules, where is the value in this game? I know you mentioned possibly looking over to the Detroit side.
Yeah, I don't know if this is necessarily value, but just a guy that I do want to mention is Jamal Williams. He's $7,200. He's not, a top-tier guy, and he's not a value guy at all. So I think for value, you know, the Lions have no receivers. So, like, rostering any of their receivers have potential value, especially as a double-digit road dog. I think MVS as a Packers wide receiver is a guy that you can look at. But I want to talk about Williams because he was the starter. Everybody thought it was going to be Swift. And Detroit said, well, this new coaching staff, well, we don't really like Swift. We're going with Jamal Williams. And now Swift is dinged up, too, with an injury. So even if he does play, he might not be 100%. You have Williams going against his former team on Monday Night Football. He had 9 carries for 54 yards with a touchdown against San Francisco last week. He caught 8 of 9 targets for 56 yards. So that tells me if this is a surprisingly close game, Williams is going to get the carries. If it goes as we expect and Detroit's playing from behind, Jared Goff's going to be dumping down, checking down to Williams out of the backfield. So Williams is a guy that I really like on this slate, whether you want to call him value or not.
Okay, the Jamal Williams revenge game. I love it, Jules. Pearce, where can you find value?
Let's stick with that narrative that the Lions are going to be behind, so they're going to be passing a lot late. Unfortunately, the checkdown options are a little pricey, but if you go to the Detroit wide receivers, they're all incredibly cheap with Tyrell Williams out with the concussion. Khalif Raymond may not be playing in this game. He's questionable. So then you've got Amon-Ra and St. Brown, maybe Trinity Benson. They cost you absolutely...
Who are these guys?
Yeah, exactly. Who are these guys? But they cost you absolutely nothing, and they'll allow you to roster basically anyone that you want. And if they're going to be playing from behind and they're going to play 60 to 70 snaps, the weather, yeah, obviously it's going to be an issue, but the volume should be there. They have an opportunity. And just, hey, whoever faces off against Kevin King probably is going to be the value play of the night.
Let's see, Paul.
Yeah, the value in this game will be in the Packers tight end Robert Tonyan, guys, and the primary running backs, of course. I think both teams will have to lean on the ground game and short passes, so I look for the big tight end to be a factor, particularly in the red zone offense, where he was a stud last year. This is also a great spot where A.J. Dillon could rise up to meet some of his preseason hype. Williams and Swift, we've talked about them in the Lions' backfield. They aren't as attractive to me in the visiting situation just because of the field conditions that I expect. And Hockenson could be the big busiest guy in the Detroit offense. More compelling play. He led the team in targets last week. I expected him to be in that position again tonight.